Good morning. Our today's topic it is related with text file operation, and today we are going to conduct a read operation on a text file. Read, right? Read means what? Read means a file is already created. It is there in your computer's hard disk. Now you have to access the file by using your Python program. You have to access the file, you have to read the content that are there inside the file, and you have to display the content either selectively, or you can display the whole content of the file on the monitor. But this process we conduct by using Python program. Generally kya hota hai, if a text file is there in your PC and you want to read the file, you just double click on the file, file opens in the Notepad software and you can read the content by using Notepad or by using any Word editor software. But here the concept is different. We are going to read the text file by using our Python program so that we can make calculations of the file, so that we can make our individual operations on the file, so that we can write our program data inside the text file. Right here, very first we are going to discuss about the read process, then afterwards we are going to cover the topic how to write our program's data into the text file. Right, so here very first the read concept. If you want to read the contents of the text file, there are three different functions in Python. Just see these three different functions. The first one, it is a read function, READ, library function. You should write this function in a small letter. The second one is read line, no space, it is a single word, read line. And the third function, it is read lines, plural term. Clear? Any doubt? So now in this video lecture, you just understand the process, understand the approach that are there in these three different functions. So our today's topic, it is somehow related with this diagram also, right? Suppose one abc.txt file, it is our computer's hard disk. Just see the diagram again. RAM is the central most part of your PC. It is RAM. It is just like the graph paper, or we can say square page. Clear? So it is RAM. You are here at this Python. It is your position. Right? You directly connected with computer's memory. Computer's memory connected with hard disk. There is no direct connection in between you and your computer's hard disk. Right? So the ABC file is here at the hard disk. It is a text file, abc.txt. The file is here. Now you just create a program to read the file by using your Python. So for that, very first work, you have to upload the file from the hard disk to your computer's memory in a specific variable. Right? It is our very first work. Just take the file from the hard disk, upload the file into computer's memory in a specific variable. Clear? So what is the process? Very first process, or we can say the first step for opening a file, just open your Python program. Here in this Python program, your first line should be pq. It is a simple file variable. Clear? Pq equal to open. Open is a by default function in Python, just like print. Clear? Open, and then just give the file name abc.txt. Ab karna kya hai? If you are going to conduct a practical, very first aapko notepad open karna hai. You have to type 1, 2, 3, 4 lines in the notepad. Clear? File read karoge, it means what? File should be there in your hard disk. So very first open your notepad software and create this abc.txt file. Aapne type kiya. Now just save the file with abc.txt name. Save again. Now it is there in the my document folder. You have to select the file from my document and you have to paste the file into the root directory of your Python, root folder of your Python, where you installed the Python language. Right, it is there in the C drive. So just create the file, copy and paste into the Python root folder. Now Come to the Python text editor. Here it is, the Python text editor. And my first line is pq equal to open abc.txt. It is relative reference of the file. Write two different things, relative path, or we can say relative reference. The second one is absolute path. You can use absolute path also. Just see the previous video. In the previous video, I told you what is absolute path, what is relative path. So here, if the file is there in the Python root folder, you just write the file name only, comma. Then we are going to open the file into reading, for the reading purpose. So here, file mode should be small r. It is for reading. Clear? Our first command, pq equal to open abc.txt comma r. Now, when computer execute this command, pq variable, it is created inside the computer's memory. It is pq variable, right? Very first computer create the pq variable, and then the abc.txt file, it is uploaded in the variable with a read restriction. You have to read that file only, you cannot write. Clear? Now, how to read the content, how to display the content, how to display all these lines that are there in the file by using your Python program. So it is the first line. Now what is there in the second line? Just see, I am going to create one string variable. It is str. Clear? And then str equal to pq. Pq is my file object, file variable, or we can say it is the file handler. Now file is loaded into this file handler. Hard disk, there is no use of hard disk now. We are working on this file variable only throughout the program. Clear? So here str equal to pq dot read, just like this one. It is the second command. Str, it is a variable. Pq, it is a file variable. Computer kya karega? Is pq ke andar jo bhi data, jo bhi content hai, kaun sa content rahega? Pq ke andar yahi to content hai. We upload the same file into this pq. So the content of pq file handle means this content, computer is going to store the content into the str string variable. The content read command returns the file data into the string format. So here str is a string variable. Now just if you write this command print str, what will happen? The data that is there in your file, the whole data is there on your Python monitor, Python output screen. Just see it. Top school, this, right? These four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4 lines are there. If you execute the program, itna sa program mein file read ka. Here, the read command read the whole file at a one time, at a single time. Ek hi baar mein puri file read hogi. Clear? Now you can use this read command into different formats. Now what are these formats? Dekho abhi, ye output aaya iska, right? Now I am going to create one more variable str2, and here I am supplying the command pq.read. pq.read5, right? You can supply a digit with the read function also. Now if you supply a digit, yes, digit is a whole number, it is not a fractional digit. Here 5 is a whole number. Now either I can write this command, by this computer read the whole content that are there inside the file. Now if I write read 5 and I am going to take the printout of string 2, print here str2, now what is the output? Computer reads first 5 letters from the file, only first 5 letters, right? Here just see, 5 letters from the current cursor position. When you open this file in the read mode, the file cursor, your file pointer, it is here at the beginning. Clear? File pointer means the file cursor, we can say. When you are going to read something, the cursor or file pointer should be at the beginning position, or we can say at the zeroth position. So here your file pointer is here. Now the command is pq.read5. It means what? Computer is going to read the 5 letters from the file, means 1, 2, 3, 4, and the space is 5. So here if you print out this one, HGIS and then one space, this is the output of this particular command, eq.read file. Clear? Now the next thing, अब मैं क्या करता हूं, अभी मैंने एक और वेरिएबल बनाया str3 equal to pq.read2. What will happen? अभी देखो, मैंने पहले कमांड दी थी read 5, it means what? At the beginning, the file pointer is at the zero position. Now, when you supply the read 5 command, these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 letters computer ने read कर लिए. Now the cursor is at the sixth position here. लिया I के ऊपर कर्सर आ गया. अब अगर आप देखो pq.read2, अब क्या होता है str3 जो अगले एलिमेंट से the next element of the file print str3 if you supply the command is is there read 2 first read 5 computer read the first 5 letter then आपने कमांड चलाई read 2 computer is going to read the next 2 letters where the cursor is. So cursor is at here. So I and S, these two letters are coming out from, then you supply the read and with this command. Right? So read command is related with the file pointer position. Clear? So just see, check this code. Now the next thing, if we use this command, the next command is read lines. Read line. Clear? Read and read line, both the commands supply file content in the string format. Clear? So you have to create a string variable, or you can use this command directly with the print command of Python. Now just see, again pq equal to open, my file name is, it is abc.txt, comma, read mode means R. Done. Now, here I am going to create one string variable str1 equal to pq.readline. Read line. It will read the file line by line. Clear? Line by line means if you arrange the read line command with this str1, only the first line of the file. It is going to store in the string variable pq.readline means what? Pahli line. The first line, only the first line that will read HGIS is. Now just see, ab main dusri line mujhe aur padhne to main kya kar raha hu? str2 equal to pq.readline again. The next command. Done. When I use the print command with str1, kya print aayega? str1 contains the first line of the file. So here the output is HGIS. Just see the content of the file HGIS, and then it is the first output. str1 holds the very first line of the file. Now again you supply the read line command. Now kya hoga? Now computer is going to read the second line of the file. So here when you supply print str2, print str2, क्या प्रिंट होगा? The second line of the file. Second line is 8th top school. So here 8th top school. It will be there on the monitor, right? So with the help of read line, you can read the file line by line. Clear out? Any doubt? Now, if you use this read line command in a loop, I told you that loop is essential if you work on the file handling in Python. While loop is there, for loop is there, you can use loop. Loop means what? Continuation. Inside the loop, if you use read line command, to continuously computer read one line, second line, third line, and so on. Clear? Now just see. So read and read line, both the functions returns the file data into the string format. Clear? Into the string format the data is written. So you have to create one string variable str1, str2. These are the string variable of Python, and then the lines of the file are going to store in the particular variable. Right? Now one more thing, with this read line also you can give a value. Suppose Now, two lines read by the computer. Computer's cursor or file pointer is here at the beginning of the third line. Right? ये सब जुड़े हुए हैं आपस में. First read line was for the very first line of the file. Read by the computer cursor is at the second line. Then फिर आपने read line दिया. Second line is covered by the by your computer. Now computer's cursor file pointer is here at the beginning of the third line. अब मैं क्या command दे रहा हूँ? Now my command is str3 equal to pq dot read line 2. Now here I am going to supply a digit with the read line function. Same digit मैंने read के साथ भी supply की थी with the read function also. What is the, what have done by the PC when you supply this read? Read 2 आपने दिया था. Computer is going to read two letters from the file pointer's position. Right? The same thing is there with read line also. Read line 2 आप करते हो. At that time, it is going to skip the whole line. It is going to read these letters from the line. So here, str3. Now if you supply print command, print str3, what will happen? It will read two letters from the cursor position, file pointer is here, OF. So the output is OF at here. Means read line 2 or pq.read 2, both are similar. Either you can use read line or you can use read 2, both are similar. These both commands read two letters from the file pointer's position. Clear? Yeah. So read line. Now we are here at this read lines command, read lines function. What is there in read line? Just see. Very first, the read line command shows, or we can say the read line command returns the file data into a list format. It is very important. Right, read command returns the file data into string format. It also returns the file data into string format. But if you use read lines command, it returns the file data into list format. Right, list format. So just see the program. pq equal to open function and then the file name, it is abc.txt. Yes. File name you can write either in capital or in a small. It is not a case sensitive only. But this read mode, file mode, it is case sensitive. It should be there in a small letter only. Clear? Acha, ek cheez aur. Now I am going to open the file into the read mode. So main isko hata bhi sakta hu. It is optional. This one is also applicable. By default, computer put the read mode with the file. Clear? Ye bhi question aata hai. What is the by default file mode? By default, file mode is read. If you not supply the file mode with the open function, computer automatically open the file in the read mode. Right? So, apne aap lag jaye. So here, now, just see, lst equal to pq dot read lines. With the read lines, you cannot use digit over here. It should be vacant, should be empty when you use this read line. Digits are applicable with read and read line function only. Read lines blank. Clear? Now what will happen? LST equal to pq dot read line, and I am going to show this LST variable. What is the output now? File content line by line is stored in the list formation. कैसे ये appear होगा, कैसे store होगा? देखो, ये आपका जो LST variable बनेगा, it looks like this one. LST, it is a list. Square bracket means it is a list. Now, what is the first line? It is here. HGIS, then is, it is the first line. Right? Just after the first line, computer put slash n as a delimiter, or we can say it is an end of line character. It is there available with each, after each and every line of the file. Clear? So just see the output. HGIS is slash n list 0th position data, it is this one. Now the dusri line, okay, the second line, 8th top school. it is there with slash n. Clear? List formation. List, zeroth position element, the first line of your file. Here it is, second line of your file. Now again, the third line of your file, of RAJ of Rajasthan, then slash s. Slash n. Slash n means new line character. Just remember, just recall the print command that you studied in class 11. Now the last line, congratulations. Slash n. So this is the formation inside the list. List is created if you use read lines function. Right? Read lines function, return the output into the list format. Ek cheez aur dekhte hain. Here, after each and every line of your file, each and every line is converted a list element, a list data in the list, and after each and every line, by default, computer puts slash n, slash n, slash n, and slash n after each and every line. Clear? So these are the file modes. These not file mode, these are the read file functions that we can use for reading a file. Clear? Now, the next thing is, you can read the whole file by using for loop also, or by using for loop or while loop also. Now, what is the condition in the file loop? Just see. If you want to read the whole file, either you can use read function. Read means the whole file content is there, or you can use read line function. Now, just see the code. My new code is pq equal to open abc.txt, and here I am going to supply the command that is, yeah, for loop. For x in pq, right? It is a for loop. For x in pq, and here with this for loop, either I can create a variable, suppose just like this one, str equal to pq. Oh, sorry, no, not applicable here. If you use for loop, very simple process, I am telling you very simple process. Just write print x over here. X for x in pq. X means it denotes each and every line of your file. For loop, the first line, it is stored in x variable. Now you have to show the x variable on the monitor. Print x is the command of it. Clear? Direct print x. It is the simplest process. X in pq, very first, when you execute the loop very first, computer is going to store the first line in the x variable, and this line is displayed on the monitor. Then again loop, second time, second line, then the second line is displayed on the monitor, then third and fourth line this way. Clear? So these are the process to read a text file from your Python program. I hope the video lecture is fruitful for you. Thank you. Thank you very much.